Right, and with that concludes the national anthems. Zimbabwe versus Australia game. Right, the umpire blowing the whistle, calling the boys, the team, two ladies teams in. And the ball goes into the Australian side. Who's going to pick it up first? It looks like it's going to be the number one for the Australians. She has a dig at it. She can't gather the balls on the ground. Who goes down? It's Paula Sparrow. Paula Sparrow has a dig at it. She can't pick it up. And it's still on the ground. The ball yet to be in control by other teams yet. And it's over the back line. Right, into the commentary boxes, Ian.
Thank you, Wayne. Right, so we've got a free throw coming out from the back line. Jane Keeper for Australia. She takes it to herself. Oh, she gets a lot of pressure put on her straight by Paula Sparrow. Paula Sparrow, umpire's whistle's gone. I think then probably going to say move it up the field. Paula Sparrow not giving Jane Keeper first chance of a ball. So we come up to the 30-yard line. Jane Keeper on the little grey horse. Takes a free throw to herself this time. She pulls it back in now, puts the pedal down upfield. She goes, getting chased by the Zimbabwean defence. Checks up midfield, turns back inside, runs herself around two Zimbabweans. Down towards the 30-yard line she goes. She's still got pressure coming onto her. Now, she'll look to link up with her number one, which I think is Lizzie Lister. Lizzie Lister takes a little pass across the 30-yard line. She's out in the corner at the moment. Big pressure coming on from Suzanne Sargent. Lizzie Lister twists, turns back towards the goals, but Suzanne Sargent blocks her way through. Lizzie Lister now. Drives across the face of goals, riding nice and slowly, taking it nice and easy early on in this chucker. She's got plenty of time, faces in towards a goal. Suzanne Sargent again turns away. Suzanne Sargent's had a good weekend in that number three shirt for Zimbabwe. Lizzie Lister round again in front of her goals, drives in again. Suzanne Sargent turns her away. Lizzie Lister comes back across the face of goals. Big one out the side, and the goal judges say yes. And Australia get us off the mark 1-0. So they'll come back to the 30-yard line. Sorry, midfield, not the 30-yard line. So in they come on umpire. I think it's Rob Jenkinson who's umpiring this side. It's down on the floor. It's mopped up by Susan Sargent for Zimbabwe. She takes a lot of timber from Jane Keeper. She holds onto it. Lizzie Lister comes and lays in a forest of timber. But still, Suzanne Sargent holds onto it now. They get the ball out of a racket. And there's not a whistle, there's plays going on, swooped on by, I think it's Sonia Mansfield in this number two shirt for Zimbabwe. Sonia Mansfield takes a big ride off from Lauren Camp, but she gets a pass away to Paula Sparrow. Paula Sparrow twisting and turning midfield. There is a forest of timber again being laid by Lizzie Lister, but Paula Sparrow gets over 30-yard line. Now, she's got to find a way around Jane Cooper in this number three shirt. Oh, big overarm shot from the edge of a D, and it's through the post. 1-1 the score, Zimbabwe level it up. So they'll go to the far side. And it will be table side of the field. And it's umpires just waiting for a straight line. And now he gives them ball down middle of a tunnel. It's in the Zimbabwean racket. It's the racket of Sonia Mansfield. She flicks it away out in front for her number one to chase. But it's Australian rackets who get there first. A couple go over top of them, but Lauren Kant doesn't. Lauren Kant now with a ball in midfield, making her way through the traffic. Zimbabwe trying to get some defence on her, turns her back, but Lauren just riding through the traffic at the moment. Nice and coolly with the ball, waiting for a chance to link up with her number one, Lizzie Lister, at the 30-yard line. Makes a break down towards the 30-yard line. Lizzie Lister makes her break, pass goes across to the racket of Lizzie Lister. Now Lizzie Lister checks up in the area, goes for a bit of a ride. She's got to find a way around Susan Sargent in this number three shirt. Lizzie Lister back out towards the 30-yard line. She goes, turns, looks at the post from the top of a D. Susan Sargent stares at her. Lizzie Lister drives around the side. Nice little shot out the side. And that's another one to Australia. 2-1 the score. They'll come back to midfield. And they'll line up on the marquee side of the field, front of the VIP area. Umpire Jenkinson will give them ball when he's happy. They're all straight and facing forwards. Ball goes in. It's down on the Zimbabwe side. Won by Sonia Mansfield. Sonia Mansfield turns the pony and gets herself out of trouble. Gets pace on going down the field towards the 30-yard line. Paula Sparrow is riding out in front. Pass goes across. Oh, it doesn't find the racket of Paula Sparrow on first tempo. She'll win it back off the ground on the bounce. Now, she's got to find a way around Jane Cooper in this Australian number three shirt. So, Paula Sparrow drives in towards the post. Cocks the arm from a big overarm. It's good. Two all the scores. Zimbabwe staying in this in the first chucker. Back towards midfield they come for another lineup. It is very hot out there. These players and these horses. I imagine the horses are, well, all these players and horses should be used to it, really. I think it's the players from countries like the UK who probably struggle more in the heat than the Australians and the Zimbabweans. So, over to the far side, the official side of the hill they go. Ball goes in and it's down. It's snapped off the bat by Jane Cooper. Jane Cooper of Australia, she throws a long ball out in front for Lizzie Lister to chase. She'll get it before the 30-yard line. She gets in the bounce. Do the umpires. The umpires, I think, saying she didn't quite get the bounce away in time. So she had to pick it up just before the 30-yard line and unfortunately just couldn't get the bounce down in time. Carried it over 30-yard line. So it's going to be a Zimbabwe turnover ball from the 30-yard line. And it's going to be taken by their number three, Suzanne Sargent. She throws a high one up to herself on the non-stick side. Oh, she doesn't get it back. Jane Cooper steals it. What do the umpires say about that? They're going to say, we're going for a long ride down the other end. Because Jane Cooper didn't give Suzanne Sargent first chance of a ball. So down to the other 30-yard line we go. And umpire, I think, telling. And that's time at the end of that one. We won't have time for the free throw, so we'll carry it over to the men's chucker, and it will be the Zimbabwe men who start with the free throw. And I think we're gonna pass you over to Harry Kirk to take you through the men.
For Zimbabwe, the number one, Craig Mannix, the number one. Terence Keith, the number two. And Hamish Michael in the number three shirt. For the Australians, Abbott Grills, Trent Collins and Will Weston. So they're underway. Chucker number two. Ball's out there by Craig Mannix. He's the number one for Zimbabwe. Mannix now. He's going to do battle down there with Weston. So a steady start to chucker number two. And Mannix around the front of Weston. And a quick reply there by the Zimbabweans to make it through three plays two. And chucker number two. So they head back over the far side of the field. Umpire calls them in straight. Ball down the tunnel. It's out the back. It's going to be Weston, the number three for Australia. First to see her. Beautiful offside. Pick up there by Weston now. He looks out. Abbott Grills well out in front. Now Weston. Weston working around. He's got two defenders to compete with now. He waits for Collins to come back and lend him a helping hand. Weston ducks on a bit of timber there. Now he's going to get this pass out to Abbott Grills. He's going to be hard marked up there by Hamish Michael. Weston directing traffic at the moment now. He comes up the quarter way. He flicks a pass into Abbott Grills, 3-2 the score. This one to be the equaliser now. Abbott Grills deep out in the corner. He has a pace away there from Michael. And there comes goal number three. Three all the score. Chucker number two. So a nice, calm, collected textbook goal there by the Aussies to tie it up 3 goals apiece. They come back now to the near side of the field. Low scoring match so far. Near side of the field, waiting. Umpire, now he's happiest down. The twos get a racket to it and straight back into the crowd. Lucky spectator gets a touch on the game ball there. So we have another go. Take all six of you, the umpire says. Come on, you've done this thousands of times before. Sure, he can do it right once more. Ball's in, the ones get a racket to it. Who's an eye for it there? Collins now, the number two for Australia. 3-all the score, chucker number two. Now Collins, he just sits up. He looks edge around the front. The long bomb downtown to Grills. Grills down the far sideline. The pace is on. He downs it, traps it, goals it. Make that goal number four. Four plays three, chucker number two. They getting a bit more confident out here, the Australian men, throwing the ball around a bit more. And there's a great display of that. So now we go back to the far side of the field. A four plays three, the score, chucker number two. Umpire certainly expressing the law. Ball's in, it's out the back. It's going to be Weston, the first receiver. A lovely turnout. The offside pick up by Weston now. He wheels a big chestnut pony around. A Collins, he thought about holding up the three in Michaels, but it's Weston getting away from traffic. Grills and Weston now. They're going to link up the quarterway. They duck away the left now. Weston, he comes a bit of chase from the Zimbabwean number one in Craig Mannix now. The pass across now. Weston holding the pass across to Grills. Grills, he'll be marked up by Hamish Michael. Away from Michael he goes. And there's another one. Australia make that five, play three, chucker number two. So now we come back to the near side of the field. Umpire waits for the straight lineup once again. Waiting. So a lot. Plenty of noise come from the Australian camp at the moment now. Abbott Grills awarded a penalty up the front. Five plays three. Chucker number two. He puts a little one out for himself. Collins now. He comes in to take a player out there. And Terence Keith now. Grills just making his way downfield. Nice, calm, collected. He's got plenty of time to move now. Grills, he puts a little bounce out in front. 5-3. Chucker number two in favour of Australia. Now Grills, he just gets a little update there from the Zimbabwean. Views of Polocrosse, a left-hander away. Abbott Grills right in front. There goes goal number six. Six plays three, half the difference. Chucker number two. Probably have the next. Far side of the field, ball's in, it's dropped there. The ones, the twos, get a racket to it. Weston out the back. He's got three so far, this chucker now. He says, we'll just offload to the man in Abbott. Grills are downfield. He's going to go. Grills and working around. He's got the pace on. Collins working overtime on the number three. Michael Grills puts a little one up on top of him. And there goes goal seven. Seven plays three. 7-3, chucker number two, dying stages. So a quick reply here by the Australian men. They put a few on the board. So they come back. Near side of the field once again, ball's in. It could be Weston, four from four. It is indeed. He's dominating out there, showing his dominance over the Zimbabweans. And the pass across to Grills. Goal number eight. 5-8, 8 plays 3, the difference. Oh, try again. 8 plays 3, 5 points the difference. And there you have it. A very strong opening chucker by the Australian men.
For the first line out of his chucker on the far side. Umpire will want them really straight for this one. First line out. Oh, it comes down Zimbabwe's side and sticks reach for it. But it's an Australian stick. It's Jane Cooper. Jane Cooper played in. This is her third World Cup, I think. Checks up in midfield. In a bit of traffic at the moment, Zimbabwe's laying in plenty of wood, but she's still holding on to it. Zimbabwe trying to get round for a shot at the racket, but Jane Cooper now gets herself out of trouble. Heads down towards the 30-yard line. To the 30-yard line she goes. Pressure on by Susan Sargent. Jane Cooper though takes a bounce on the safe side and then drives across the face of goals. Doesn't do the shot out of the side. Comes away, circles back up towards the top of the area. Jane Cooper just taking her time. Australia have the lead here. Jane Cooper checks up, looks at the post. Susan Sargent just stopping that shot at the moment, going over the top of her head. Jane Cooper back round again to face up in front of goals. Drives in. Oh, again, Susan Sargent turns away. This time, Jane Cooper just checks in behind her and then throws a little one round the side of her and makes it 9-3. So they'll come back, line up on the marquee side of the field. And umpire just gets back to the tee and they'll call them in. Ball goes in, it's up off the sticks of the ones, it's coming back towards the sideline. Oh, Paula Sparrow reaches out a long way and manages to grab it. Umpire not happy with something. I think with a swing of an Australian stick. So I think we're going to be moved up to the... Oh. My. So... We are going. I think it's been a free goal. So free goal to Zimbabwe for the swing, and it's 9-4. So they go to the far side of the field. They'll line up again. Umpire sends them away, tells them to come back in and get straight for this line out. They come together. And again, the umpire's not happy. There's still problems at the twos and the threes. Umpire again sends them all away and says, come back in and try again. So they come together now. Umpire now gives them ball. It's down the middle of a tunnel. It's out the back and it's Lucy Grills. But there's a big whistle on. And the umpire at the back has said, I think, might be turning out the line out early. I'm not sure what the call was for, but it's been moved down to the 30-yard line. So we will go from the 30-yard line with Zimbabwe, with their number one, Paula Sparrow, who's got a new number three up against her in Lucy Grills, this chucker. Let's see how she goes against her. Paula Sparrow takes a little 10-metre throw to herself. Can't pull in the first or second attempt, but pulls it in the third, but big pressure coming in from Lucy Grills. Nearly drives her over the 30-yard line, but Paula Sparrow manages to get back into the 30-yard area. Twists and turns in front of goals. Lovely 360 out of a pony. And puts her in front of a post to put it through to make it 9-5. Zimbabwe are staying in this. 9-5 the score. 2-1 in this chucker. They'll come back and line up on the marquee side of the field. In front of all the presidents and the dignitaries. Ball goes in, comes straight off of one's rackets and comes over sideline. And it will be another lineup. Umpire tells all six to line up again. Together they come again. Umpire gives them ball. Oh, it landed kindly in Lucy Grills' racket as she was turning out, and now she goes downfield. Takes a bit of a turn in midfield. She's getting chased around by the Zimbabwean defence, but Lauren Cant doing a good job taking away one Zimbabwean defender. The twos are often forgotten about, but they're always working very hard. Downfield she goes now. Lucy Grills flicks the pass, goes to Jane Cooper. Jane Cooper comes under pressure from Suzanne Sargent. Jane Cooper drives it towards the waist, lays out the side, throws it through from a tight angle right in front of Suzanne Sargent, horse's nose. Nice little goal by the Australian number one. Vastly experienced number one, and nice little goal. Easy for her, probably. Not so easy for the rest of us. 10-5. Australia level it up in this chucker. Ball goes in and it's down on the floor and it's picked up by a Zimbabwe stick. I think it's a stick of Paula Sparrow. Paula Sparrow runs past the Australian sticks, who have a swing at her, but she makes past all of them. Another big swing comes in from Lucy Grills as she gets over the 30-yard line. And she makes a bounce, but Paula Sparrow still has the ball. She's in the 30-yard area. So in the 30-yard area, Paula Sparrow working hard against Lucy Grills. Lucy Grills is working very hard, keeping away from those posts. Back out towards the top of the area. They come up. Paula Sparrow checks in behind. Big overarm, but there was a whistle on before she shot it. And the umpires are going to come in and have a bit of a chat. And we'll see what they say. I think maybe the swing from Lucy Grills they weren't happy with. We'll see what they say. I think that they might have given a free goal for the swing. Anyway, ball's back in. It's flicked over top by Sonia Mansfield. Sonia Mansfield won it in the middle for Zimbabwe. Flicks it over top to Paula Sparrow. Paula Sparrow at the 30-yard line. Bounce, trap, shoots and scores. Zimbabwe had another one on the board. 10-7. In the dying stages of this third chuck of the Zimbabwe ladies are fighting hard. They've dragged themselves back into this. 10-7. Only 3 goals in it. Ball goes in. Snapped over front by Sparrow. Paula Sparrow wins one off the front of Jane Cooper. Jane Cooper won't like that. Paula Sparrow down to the 30-yard line. Bounces. Can't pull it back in. Oh, pulls it in a second and then has to throw it back in field before she gets carried over the 30-yard line. But a whistle went. And what did the whistle say? Well, we won't find out until the start of the next chucker, I don't think.
So it appears to be no change to the Zimbabweans. It's only 2 points in it. Very strong chucker from the men last chucker. Weston had a great run out the back there. So we're about to get back underway in chucker number 4. 8-10. Favour of Australia. Not quite happy with the lineup there, so the umpire calls time on. And awards it straight to Grills. Jim Grills it is to restart the play out here. Grills just puts a little one out to himself. Just sits up. Oh, his man do a great job at giving him a clear path down the main street of Chongwani here. Now down he goes. He comes up to the first set of traffic lights. Ducks away to the right. Puts a pace on. Grills. Goal number 11. Make it look easy. Make it look easy out here, the Australians. But I can assure you, no easy task. So we come back to near side of the field. Umpire calls him in. Waits for a straight lineup. Really enforcing the lineups here, the umpires. Ball's in. This time it's out there for the three. Once again, Weston on the offside. Oh, he leaned right out of the saddle, nearly dismounted. Now it's going to be picked up by Zimbabwe. It had it lost. It regathers now. The number two shirt it is out here. Terrence Keith. Keith winding up around, around, around. They hunt in pairs. The Australia. Grills there. Iggy's he one. Iggy's he two, three, four, and five for good luck. Grills with the stick on. Whistle on. So hitting down, possibly the call there. So it's going to be taken down there by Craig Mannix now. Mannix to restart outside, going in from the Zimbabwean goal scoring area. He'll be met down there by Weston now. And Mannix, he works around, looks across the face of the post, just works back the other way. Mannix sits off him, ducks and dives over the top. Waved away, maybe a little more time to go into that one. Waved away there. So Weston to restart play now. He just puts a little one out to himself out in front. Weston comes back around downfield. He's going to go. This is Will Weston now. Weston, he comes up the quarterway. The long pass out to Grills. Grills takes it in. A lovely left-hander opens up the goalpost. The pony has a little trip, but no worries there. 4 points in front now, the Australians. Ball's in. It's out the back. Weston's lost the racket, so he says, I'll just try and pick my man up. Collins with the offsider. What a pick up there by Trent Collins now. Collins, he makes his way downfield. He's got to get a pass into Grills. Grills will be marked up down there by Hamish Michael. The pass across to Grills. Michael late on the scene. Around the front, he might go. And there he goes for goal number 13. 13 plays 8. Chucker number 4. 13-8. So they come back now, the near side of the field. Grills plucks one up the front. I was actually looking away. I don't know how he got it. I'd say he caught it. Now Grills downfield he goes. He's just directing traffic, looking for a clear path. Weston tries to give him a bit of guidance there. Grills downs it into the goal scoring area. He goes now. He says, we're in front. We've got the ball. What more could you want on a Sunday afternoon, morning, around the front? He looks to go with Michael, Hamish, Michael, or Grills. They do battle down there. Now, the cat and mouse game. He looks to go across the face. Grills, angle shot. And there goes another one for Australia. Very strong, this men's chucker today. Ball's in, long and hard, out the back. We get to see the best of pickup. Weston down on that one like a seagull on a chip at Bondi Beach, but it's Weston now. He just sits up about the halfway mark, gets a bit of room to move, down towards the quarterway. Got to get the pass across to Grills now. Weston to Grills, they come together. The nod of the head, the take of the racket now. The left-handed wheel from Grills, a push-button pony's out here. Now he works across the face of the pace. He'll be marked up there by Hamish Michael. Just puts backs a pony into him, stands up in the irons, around the front he goes. Goal number 16, 16-8. Just fixing up the bridle there at Grills. Now ball's in Western. The long bomb downtown. It's got wings, that ball, but this man's got legs. Around he goes. 16 plays 8. A very quick goal. And the downtown sort of polo cross we like to talk about. And as we tail off chucker number 4. So, just have a bit more time off out here.
The players tap sticks and wish each other good luck, as is traditional for first and last chuckers in polo cross. And they'll go and line up for the first line out of this fifth chucker over on the official side of the field in front of the secretary's box. And where the scorers and the timekeepers are, don't always believe the official scoreboard. The time on that won't be 100% accurate. It will be 100% accurate in the box. It's in, it's out the back, and it's a freeze. You'll see the first of it. And it's Susan Sargent. She's on it like a fat kid on a cupcake. Susan Sargent wins ball out the back for Zimbabwe. She's getting a hell of a lot of timber swung at her by Lizzie Lister. But she checks up, goes around her, makes her way downfield. Towards the 30-yard line, she goes. More timber being laid by Lucy Grills. The Australians doing their best impressions of lumberjacks and laying in lots of timber, but it had its desired effect, because the throw from Susan Sargent was not 100% accurate, and his ball's gone out the back, and it's going to be a free throw to Jane Cooper. Jane Cooper now from the back line. Oh, she says, surely she can't ride in there, umpire, and stop me getting first chance of a ball, and the umpire agrees, and they'll move it up to the 30-yard line. So Jane Cooper gets moved up to the 30-yard line with a free throw now. Up she comes. She's got Paula Sparrow sitting just behind her. I think the umpire's going to say you need to be away 10 metres, really. So Jane Cooper pops a little pass out to Lizzie Lister. Lizzie Lister lets her pony go in midfield. Upfield she goes. A Zimbabwean fence chase her down. Turn her back. Lizzie Lister now in between Paula Sparrow and Sonia Mansell, but she twists her way out of trouble. Downfield she goes towards the 30-yard line. Gets turned away by Susan. Oh, puts down the power again. Drives around the front, but she's in the corner. Susan Sargent laying in lots of pressure, but Lizzie Lister somehow twists her way out of it and finds her way towards the goals and shoots it through. Lovely work by Lizzie Lister in the Australian number one shirt. Makes it 17-8 early on in this fifth chucker. In towards the lineup they come. Ball goes in. It's down by the freeze. Oh, Susan Sargent's won it again. Again, the big swings from Jane Cooper. But I don't think the umpire likes the circular swing in action. Jane Cooper doing an excellent impression of a helicopter. But unfortunately, it's not really allowed. So downfield they'll go. Circular swinging. And down to the 30-yard line they'll go. And it will be the number one for Zimbabwe. Paula Sparrow, who will take the free throw. She takes it quickly to herself, pulls it back in. Jane Cooper's there between her and the post. She says, I might have given away the free throw, but I'm not going to give you an easy goal. Paula Sparrow twists and turns. Oh, lovely 360 out of a pony again. These ponies, they can move like ballerinas. And that one, Paula Sparrow is riding, has got a beautiful turn on it. Seen it a couple of times in this game, just for check and the spin. And it leaves Jane Cooper's pony a little bit for dead. So, Paula Sparrow drags one back for Zimbabwe. 17-9 the score. These Zimbabwe ladies are not going down without a fight. Ball goes in, it's out the back again, and again it's going to be Susan Sargent who gets it. Oh, amazing pickup by Susan Sargent. Unfortunately, she couldn't quite hold it. She reached behind herself to drag it, and unfortunately, the stick wrapped around her own neck pretty much. Jane Cooper's won it off the ground, and she's popped it across to Lizzie Lister. Lizzie Lister, well, there's, I mean, the umpires. So, Jane Cooper won it off the ground. Won it off the ground after Susan Sargent had been forced to drop it again. Lizzie Lister took the pass across the 30-yard line from Jane Cooper. Jane Cooper carried on into the area and sort of blocked Susan Sargent's run. So it's a turnover ball to Zimbabwe. And Susan Sargent gets a free throw from the 30-yard line. Susan Sargent takes it herself, pulls it back in now. She pops it across to her number one in Paula Sparrow. Paula Sparrow. Oh, big swing comes in from Lucy Grills, and that sounded like head. We'll see what the umpires say. I think umpire Rob Jenkinson saying, sounded like a helmet shot to me. So that's, I think, it's going to be a free goal to Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe Well, we'll see whether the scoreboard ticks over. Yes, it does. 17-10 the score. And they'll come and line up on the marquee side of the field. This is some exciting stuff from these ladies. They are playing for keeps. And the Australians, even though they've got a bit of a lead, they are going hard. Ball in. This time it's down on the Australian side. Jane Cooper sees it. Jane Cooper wins it for Australia. Jane Cooper now gets a big ride off coming in from Paula Sparrow. Turns her back in the field. But they'll love to get someone round about stick side. The Zimbabweans have a swing at her. But Jane Cooper slips round the far side. Pops a little pass across the top of Susan Sergeant. Lizzie Lister. Lizzie Lister in front of the post. Shoots it through. And that's another goal to Australia. 18-10 the score. So the ladies, hard fast stuff out there from these ladies. They'll all have a drink together later on, but at the moment they are battling for all their worth to try and make sure their team wins this match. Australia have the upper hand, 18-10 in this fifth chucker. Umpire sends them away on the official side of the field. Ball goes in. It's down on the floor and it's Suzanne Sargent. Suzanne Sargent, she is having a big last chuck of a Zimbabwe in his number three shirt. It's like she's got a magnet in the racket and the magnet wants ball. Ball across now to Paula Sparrow. Paula Sparrow in front of a post, shoots it through. Zimbabwe are fighting hard. 18-11 the score. Suzanne Sargent, she is winning ball in this last chucker for Zimbabwe. And now they'll come and line up. Suzanne Sargent, she's played in a few World Cups. I think maybe all four, at least three of them. Ball goes in, it's out there. Oh, this time Jane Cooper snaps it off the back of the line-out. Suzanne Sargent was already turning out. Jane Cooper just stayed there and caught it. Now downfield, Jane Cooper goes. In comes the Zimbabwean defence. They give her a swing as they ride by, but she doesn't make contact. Now the pass goes across to Lizzie Lister. Lizzie Lister can't win it off the floor there. It's there in the corner for Suzanne Sargent. It's getting dangerously close to that sideline. Lizzie Lister comes back in. They fight for it. They're both trying to try and pick up the ball, but neither of them want to step over sideline. Both of them trying to protect it. Suzanne Sargent drags it back in. Suzanne Sargent in the number three shot. This is a big last chucker from her. Twists and turns, tries to find a way up the video. Pops a bomb out towards Paula Sparrow. And that's time at the end of that one, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a big round of applause. They put on a hell of a display for you, these latest teams. 18-11 at the end of the 18-11 at the end of a fifth.
Ball's in, it's long and hard, it's out the back, it's going to be picked up there, nice pick up by Michael, yes, a long bomb out in front there, that's going to be Terence Keith, the hitter with plenty of pace on, Keith right in front, the overhander, 12 plays, 18, 18-12, chucker number six. Near side of the field, ball's in. Keith got a racket almost to it. Almost. Near side of the field now. This time it's in. It gets past the ones, the twos and the threes. It's going to be picked up out the back by Michael. No, he had it, lost it, still on the ground. This time he's good enough to get back for it now. This man, Hamish Michaels now, he just checks up out of trouble. The long pass out in front. Who's underneath that one? Yes, Lawrence Keith. Keith, quarter way, traps it. Look now, he's going to get around this defence of Weston. Weston just sitting off him now, Will Weston. Lawrence Keith. Terence Keith. Sits off him, the high one over the top. And there goes another goal for Zimbabwe on the comeback trail. Ball's in, it's going to be out the back there, picked up here by the number three. Yes, he flicks a pass across, they've got three quick ones, this chucker, the Zimbabweans. Now the Zims, they make it down through the racket of Terence Keith, comes up the quarterway, he's on his own, downs it, traps it. Oh, Weston, the eagle eye, the supremacy eye of Weston. Whistle on, what's going to go? A missed attempt at goal, ruled by the umpires. Weston restarts play. Gruel says, I'll take it now. He stretches the pony out. They hit the speed limit at 125 kilometres an hour. Gruel, he traps it. He goals it. And a reply for the Aussies, 19-13. I think our main man, Wayne, is headed down towards the Aussie end to have a quick word. Abbott Grills, the number one for Australia, but he's been outdone up the front there by the man in that, Lawrence Terence Keith now. Keith makes his way up towards a 30-yard line. Weston right there waiting for him. He downs it now. Keith or Weston do battle deep out the corner. Now he's got to get around this defence once again to Weston. He gets a whiteboard marker out, sees... goes back to the drawing board and sees how he can get through this solid defence. After failing last time, he ducks away the left. Go. Ball's in now, the deflected out the Zimbabwean side, but crashing through the middle, Abbott Grills. But it appears to be lined up. No control of the ball, so we have another go, take two. The director over there in the black and white. Minute 30, chucker number 6, 19-14. It's plucked up the front by the Zimbabwean number one. It's going to be a foot race now. Who's winning the 100-meter sprint? It looks like it's going to be, yes, Keith out in front. Downs it, traps it, goals it. So a little too much, a little too late may be the case for the Zims. But I'm sure they'll fight till the very end. So things, not only the temperature starting to heat up now, it's going to be at the back, the first to see it, looks like it'll be Michaels, he picks it up and there's Keith out in front, he says you better offload it, Grills there giving him a heap and a heap. Whistle on, face on, chat on, talk on. So as I said, it's not only the temperature getting warmed up out here. But I'm sure they'll all happy to have a beer after the game. A great ideology of polocrosse, what happens on the field stays on the field. So we get back underway through the racket here of this man in Terence Keith now. Keith, he'll be working through this defence of Weston. Just works across the face of the goalpost. Tail stages, chucker. Number six, the overhander. They're giving that one. So there's the final score, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together.